All right, everybody. Take a seat. Tran, right up front here. Okay.
Oh, good.
Tran, right here.
Yeah.
I'll sit up here.
I'll be in front of him.
Okay, what week is this?
Pickle. You know who I am? I'm Captain Pickle. My character's head is Pickle. And, you know, I like Joe Tylock because, you know, where else could a pickle superhero get a job if it weren't for that pickle-sucking Joe Ty? Pickle-sucking, that reminds me, where's my pickle? I told him to have my pickle here. You know, you can never get good help these days. They're always just doing, oh, there it is. You know what's better than sucking on a pickle?
What?
Nothing. But I'm pickle. So
why are you joining our staff today?
Well, no, I wanted to make everybody know about the pickle jars. Have you seen those pickle jars? They're awesome. They're like my brothers. So, you know, you've never seen Captain Pickle and Joe tie together at the same time. So you know what that means, right? So, I've been watching, you know, toxic emotional negativity. I love it. So, tomorrow is a pickle feeding day. We make sure you feed the pickle, and I'll be watching. I'll be watching.
Okay, Pam, do you want to say anything?
I do.
So tomorrow is the Feed the Pickle Day, so we want everybody to feed your pickle with whatever you can. We want positive that could have been negative. We want negative that really needs to double the amount that goes in the pickle. But we want you to feed those pickle jars as much as you can tomorrow. And we're going to have a little contest between departments. So if you'll just send in a little note what you did to feed your pickle and how you filled it up. Our goal is to be able to get $500 from our facility because we want Joe Ty to match the $500. So even if you think, gosh, this could have been negative if I said it in a different way, throw something in that pickle jar. We want everybody to donate. You know, if everyone put in $2, we'd have that $500 just like that. So feed the pickle, positive, negative, maybe half positive, half negative, whatever you can. Fill those jars up tomorrow and then email us with what you did.
It's a great cause.
Great.
We're going to go all over the agenda. I mean, we're not following it, but we will cover everything by the end. But we're going to do service projects next. So, you're going to start us out. So, you can. Yeah, you can.
Matt, speak loudly because I don't have.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you.
All right, so first I get to talk about our service project. For physical therapy, we decided to help somebody in the Thane community. This lady in particular, all right. I haven't looked at the slides very well before. I didn't make them, so. Anyway, so we were taking care of a patient who relied heavily on a walker to leave her house, and from the driveway to her porch was grass. And so obviously during the winter, it's either grass or snow, and which obviously difficult and unsafe with the walker. So she was unable, for many reasons, to get a sidewalk put in, so we took on the challenge. We were lucky enough to have Dave Johnson's father-in-law, who is a concrete specialist. That's what we'll call him. And he's the gentleman in the cowboy hat there to help us out and get it done right. We had way too many people for the job, but it got it done nice and fast. And it turned out great. So if we can go to that last couple. We got the whole pull crew there at different times, and first time I'd ever done something like that, so that was a lot of fun. And to help the lady, she's the gal there in the pink. It's good to be there with her. We even got to put our hands in there, so we'll be there. We'll be there forever. Secondly, I get to speak on the wellness program. How is everybody doing with the wellness program?
Pretty well.
Pretty well. Good. I like it. I like it. All right. So first, I want to share a little video.
Some kind of workout. I don't know what to do. I want to do something easy. There's no such thing, you know? I thought yoga was easy. I went out and bought a yoga videotape. I bought the beginner's yoga tape. I couldn't do anything in a whole hour. Nothing. Just fast forwarding, huh? Can't do that. Can't do that. Can't do that. I know I can't do that. This woman, like in a soothing voice, simply take the bottom of your right foot and place it on the small of your back. Now take your left leg, throw it over the back of your neck like a scarf, and breathe. I can't breathe. He had a thing called the relaxation pose, which I couldn't even do. But what kind of shape am I in? I can't relax. I couldn't do it. It's time for the relaxation pose. Kneel down on the floor with your toes pointed back behind you. Sit down on your heels and relax. I can hear my feet bones cracking. Relax. If you wanted me to relax, you should say, go get your favorite pillow. Curl up on the couch. Throw this tape away.
So I just wanted to take a minute or so to figure out what we can do better with wellness, what we're doing right with wellness. Does anybody have any comments on how wellness, the wellness program itself is going? Has anybody been on the website recently? Does anybody know what the website is? What's the website?
The website is where you go, and they have, like, the different classes. I did one of the classes. It was great.
All right.
Like, 3 weeks class thing.
Snar. Everybody answered a question. Get hard.
Yeah. But, no, yeah, they have all different types of classes. Anything from, like, 6-week classes. I took the 3-week class because life's been crazy, and it felt like something I could do.
It was on time management.
It was on time management. I managed it. And everybody could. And then they have, like, the counseling that you can do, and, yeah, it's a pretty cool website, actually.
Yeah. I think the classes are pretty good. A lot of them, I think, without looking at it, you're like, oh, that's going to take a lot of my time. But I also took the time management one, and they were all very short little reads. I mean, what, maybe 2-3 minutes a read?
If even, yeah.
Very, very, very easy. Mike's going to tell you about one of his classes that he took that he enjoyed. But there's a lot of good ones there. Anybody else have any constructive criticisms for the wellness program?
I haven't been on there for a while, but I couldn't find where to enter in stuff. I couldn't be there.
Thank you. Okay, so yeah, we need to do a better job, obviously, to help you guys understand where to put stuff in. I agree that the website, although there is a lot of good stuff in there, it is a little bit cumbersome. Unfortunately, we can't change that, but we can educate you on how to get there. Anybody else have?
Well, speaking as somebody who's slightly technologically challenged, just a little bit.
Are you talking about yourself, or are you talking about others?
Well, I wouldn't admit it, but yeah. Okay. I thought it was really really hard to try to navigate through it and to find anything I wanted to find in it. And I guess it's probably just because I didn't know or didn't understand the training or something.
Yeah, I think that's what somewhere where we could definitely improve is help you guys navigate through it a little bit better. I want to get a survey out pretty soon to kind of get feedback from you guys of what we can do a little bit better on it, and so that we can improve over the next year. And please give us ideas of new things that we can do, new activities or awards or whatever you guys think, because this ultimately is your wellness program, and we want it to succeed. So thank you for your comments. Mike, I don't know, you next.
Thanks, Matt. Thanks for taking a few minutes today to share that fun video and talk to us about our wellness program. I wanted to give everyone a little bit of statistical information regarding the program. I would tell you about my experience on the website, but everybody makes fun of me last week. More rude and inappropriate.
Well, I thought they put a quarter in the jar.
Did you do 18 gracefully like I did too?
Yes.
Yeah. Well, I do.
Everybody was rude about that. Yeah. So, you know what? We have about 285 employees here, so I don't know. And 144 people have completed at least one incentive activity. So remember, we have five different levels. And if you achieve the first level, which is the scout level, in the proper time frame, you are entered into a drawing, right? Anybody remember what that first incentive was to be in that drawing? What did you have to do to get in that drawing?
Log on.
Yeah.
Biometric
screen, right? Yeah. Entering that information into your login on the biometric screen. Okay, so 143 people did that, and they got entered into that drawing. So the next level is called the tracker level, and 69 people qualified for the tracker level drawing. You see a trend here. And the third level is the guide level, and 11 people qualified to be in the drawing for the guide level. Those are pretty good odds for those people, weren't they? I think we gave away 10 items. 11. It's one sad person didn't win that prize. Is that trend? Okay, the last level is the trailblazer level, and nobody is qualified for that. Oh, I'm sorry, I need to go back. The pioneer level is the fourth level. And that one, you have to have all of those incentives done before September 30th, which is not too far away, 1 week from today. And we're giving away 5 Fitbits to those who qualify to win the raffle. Right now, your odds are pretty good. 10 people have gotten there. So you've got good odds of winning a Fitbit if you'll get your incentive done on the pioneer level. And of course, the trailblazer level, that's the top level. We're going to give away, is it one or two? You give away one or two, Matt? Do you remember?
Two.
Give away two things on the trailblazer. That's the ultimate challenge. You've done 5 incentives. You've done all the things you've been required to do in the wellness program this year to get to this drawing. Nobody's done it yet, but there are some awesome gifts. Like you can get a DSLR camera. You can get a kayak. You can get cross-country skis for two. And there's all kinds of really cool gifts that you can get on the last one. So I want to encourage everybody to participate in that. So this, as Matt said, we want to make this employee wellness program something that will benefit you and you feel like you want to be involved with. We've learned some things from you today and from the earlier session. We're gonna put the wellness program icon out on your desktop so you can it's a little more, I say, oh, I see that once in a while, rather than having to search for it. We will get you some training, probably through the Friday flyer, as to how to get to where you need to go to enter your stuff in. And again, I would just like to encourage everybody to go into that and snoop around in it and find your way around and see some of the cool stuff that's in there that you can learn about your health and you can learn how to age gracefully like I feel like I need to right now. And you can learn about other things regarding your health, not just exercise and diet, but all kinds of stuff about being a well-rounded, healthy person. Kathy?
So if you haven't finished some of the other ones, can you catch up to get to
yes,
that
you
point?
Can. As long as you have the Trailblazer one done, or if you haven't done the rest of, up to Pioneer, if you get them done and Pioneer done by the 30th of the month, you can be entered in Pioneer. For the Trailblazer, you've got everything done, all five done by the 31st of December, you qualify for the Trailblazer. So, still a chance, good odds.
Now most of the online modules do take, one of them takes three, so most of them take 6 weeks to do. And so, if you haven't started yet, you may not be eligible for this one, but there's plenty of time to get by the end of the year.
But you can do a counseling thing instead.
Right.
Is one that, or the other.
I don't know how long the counseling sessions ask, but do I've always I just
I think
did
you
the
have
online.
To do five sessions.
Yeah.
Okay.
And so I imagine they're once a week. So, so if you haven't done that part yet, September probably isn't going to work. But you can definitely get the end of the year prize.
So if you haven't put your service project in as one of the items, because we one of the service project qualified as one of the items you can put in for the incentive, if you haven't done that, that's the way you can. You can get that done and advance your incentive a little bit more. So, thanks everybody.
Thank you, Mark. Did we lose our Pickle?
No, he wasn't.
Yes, he.
Okay. I find
he left.
Okay.
He changed again.
That's all right. We're bouncing all over. That's okay. Let's do new.
There's others from the department.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, there we go. You guys want to talk about your service project? Put you on the spot.
Sure, go ahead.
It's almost self-explanatory.
We got some wood. Yeah, we just went and got some wood for search and rescue. They have some cabins. We've got some wood to help them prepare for the long winter ahead.
And there's Eli if he wants to say anything. Tell him about your service project.
That's what we did. You know, we went up to Pocatox and whatever, Poison Meadow, did wood for the warming huts. We've got this thing set to be prepared to music, so enjoy.
It was awesome.
It was great.
That's a great project.
I'm a lumberjack and I'm okay. I sleep all night and I work all day.
He's a lumberjack and he's okay. He sleeps all night and he works all day.
I cut down trees, I eat my lunch, I go to the lavatory. On Wednesday I go shopping and have buttered scones for tea.
He cuts down trees, eats his lunch, he goes to the lavatory. On Wednesday he goes shopping and has buttered scones for tea. He's a lumberjack and he's okay. He sings all night and he works all day.
So next time we got a couple more that are going to present, right?
Yeah, we've got next month, when we meet in November, it will be MLB and also radiology. And then care center and the nursing staff are still working on theirs. So theirs will be upcoming. We'll get a report then. So thank you, everybody. This has been a great year for service.
Okay. Mindy, would you come up here? I'm hearing some groaning from the audience. So does everybody know that Mindy's going to be leaving us?
I was going to cry. Now I'm crying again.
Now that I said that, now you got
to stay. Now I have to talk. I know.
Oh.
It was a hard decision. I'm really sad to leave, obviously, but it's what's best for my family. I'll just be 10 minutes from home instead of 45 minutes. So, but it's hard. It's been a hard decision. And I'll miss everybody. I've enjoyed working with everybody. So, anyway, we have some new hires. We have Cammy Finley in the care center, and I believe she's here. You want to stand up?
Hello. We're from Montana.
Welcome.
First time living in Wyoming, I like it.
Awesome. I love Wyoming too. We have Dan Wood, the nurse practitioner in Thane, in Alpine. We have Tyler Denny in housekeeping. And we have Deanne Jackson back in medical records. And make them all feel welcome, and I will miss everybody.
Are we still going to get paid?
That is questionable.
For a couple of weeks.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm just going to mention here about smoking. Actually, it's tobacco use. When we get to January 1st, our health insurance plan is changing to where there will be a surcharge for your premium. It's $50 per individual that's on our health insurance plan. And we've discussed this before. I just want you guys to all be aware that it's coming. And and there's still time to, if you want to do something about that and not pay the $50 surcharge, then there's time to do that.
Charlie, can I just add something onto that? If you or a fellow employee you know wants to get enrolled in a smoking cessation program, that is available through the employee wellness website. CompSite does provide smoking cessation courses and assistance. And so if you know somebody who wants to kick the habit, they can do that. And if you're enrolled in the program, you don't get the surcharge. You have to be enrolled in the program.
So is the surcharge like a one-time thing, or?
A monthly surcharge to your health premiums.
Okay. Did all of our wellness stuff. Joel, looks like you're up.
So in October, we celebrate breast cancer awareness. One of the things that we've got going on right now, and it'll continue on for a little while, is there's a group of hospitals here in the region that have put together the Teton Pinky Promise. Has anybody heard of that? Kathy, you're shaking your head. What do you know about the Teton Pinky Promise? Yeah. Not much?
Other than they promised to get somebody to get a mammogram.
That's part of it. Idaho and Wyoming are the 48th and 49th worst states in the nation in terms of women getting mammography. And so what the Pinky Promise is we would like women to schedule an appointment to talk to the healthcare providers about breast health and cancer awareness and so forth. If it's time for a mammography, get that scheduled. If it's not, just learn when it is time and what you should be watching for. Awareness is the key. Breast cancer, once it's found, it's easy to take care of. It doesn't have to be a killer, and so we're wanting that taken care of. If you're a male, you can also get breast cancer, but part of the Pinky Promise we want you to do is to talk to the women in your life and have them take the Pinky Promise. So you can actually go to the website, it's TetonPinkyPromise.com, and you can go on there and register that you're taking the Pinky Promise. We're also going through the facility and getting some photos. We've got some pink surgical gloves, and we're getting like the business services building got together and did a big picture of everybody with the gloves on that were getting uploaded. We had the Wyoming affiliate of the Susan G. Komen Association here last week. We took those ladies down to the mammography machine, and they put on their pink gloves and got their picture taken. So if you've got some fun idea how you'd like to do that, we're going to try and get the Weber State students to do it as well. Let's get your picture and get it uploaded in there. But please go to the website, TetonPinkyPromise.com, and take the promise if you would, and talk to other people in the community. There is an article in this week's newspaper. It's been in the Friday Flyer, Facebook, and so forth, so we're trying to get that out. Locally, some things we're doing for breast cancer awareness is the first Wednesday of October is always, what do we do?
Break for breakfast.
Break for breakfast. So between 7 and 9 a.m.,
as you're driving to work, we're going to have a table set up front where you can pick up continental breakfast and some literature about breast cancer awareness. This year we've got some drawstring bags. They are pink camo. If you're not a real manly man, we do have green camo for you as well. But we'll have those in Alpine, Thane, Afton, and Cokeville between 7 a.m. and 9 on Wednesday the 7th. Pass out. If you would like to help stuff those bags, give Pam Wolfley a phone call. That'll be Tuesday the 6th in the afternoon. We'll be up here stuffing those bags real quick. If you want to come by and pick up a bag, again, it's between 7 and 9. That day, we'll also be having our first walk-in mammo day. So again, talk to your community members. You do not have to have an appointment that day. Between 9 and 4, you can just show up here at the hospital and get your mammography. If you know people that are uninsured or underinsured, we do have financing to help with the mammography and the radiology reading as well. Contact Pam Wolfley or myself or somebody in radiology about that or any of the MAs. We've got information from our local Rotary who raises funds, and we distribute those through the foundation. On the 15th, we're going to be sponsoring a high school volleyball game. So if you'd like to go down and support the teams, we'll be down there as well. All the cheerleaders, I have a little pink tattoo on. We've got some bracelets we're going to throw out to the crowd that have a volleyball on them and say spike cancer. And then Friday night, we're going to sponsor the high school football game that night. We're going to be there as well. So come out and support there. And then on the 21st, in the afternoon, we're down in Cokeville, we're going to have a mammography open house. We're going to have Crystal down there and just kind of an open house for that community to talk about the services that we have. And then on the 22nd is our last mammography walk-in day, and that'll be from 3 p.m. till 7 p.m. so we can catch people after work as well. So watch the Friday flyer, watch the Facebook page, and we'll get that information out for you. Any questions, ideas? Are we missing anything?
So the whole month of October, your mammogram is actually discounted.
Correct. Sorry, I forgot that. It's 25% discount off of the price, also 25% discount off the reading. Insurance, you can get your mammography 1 year plus 1 day. So if you haven't had one in October, my recommendation is go towards the first of the month. That way for the next 30 years, you could get it done in October. Okay? Thank you very much.
Thank you, Joel. All right, provider update. As you can tell, we're growing. Our volumes are growing in a lot of areas and a lot of places, so that means more providers. And we've added a nurse practitioner, well, actually two, you know, Sean Knighton and then also Dan Wood, both in doing Thane and Alpine. We are looking for a nurse practitioner for the Afton Clinic because our providers here can't keep up with the volume, which is a good thing. And so actually tomorrow we're interviewing somebody for that position, a nurse practitioner. So hopefully that will go well. Also, we are advertising and recruiting for an anesthesiologist because of our opening our new space in the operating room. We're going to have three operating rooms that can be doing surgery at the same time, which means we need another anesthesia provider. And we're going to be interviewing the first candidate in October. So we've already selected dates to interview that. And then we haven't finalized it, but it's probably in the next couple of weeks we will begin advertising for two hospitalists that will handle our patients in the inpatient side of of our operation, because we right now it's our family practice doctors that are really rounding on all of our patients on the inpatients, and they are so busy and so tied up with both the emergency room and their clinics that they're having a hard time doing that this time wise, because again we're getting busier, our census is going up. So we will be hiring two, and what they'll probably do is like a 7 day on, 7 day off rotation. And they will be doing the rounding on our patients, admitting the patients, rounding them, and then discharge of the patients. And that's an area that we really need some help with, that we're just not, as you can attest, I mean, it's just not going the way we want it to. We need to provide better care. And with additional surgeries, additional inpatients, we're at a point, we're growing at a point where that's something that's very needed for our community. And so, exciting things happening on the provider update. And I'm going to go out of order here a little bit because I'm watching Chrissy here, and I got two things that we got at the Hospital Association a couple of weeks ago. And one is, and I'll just read this, it says, presented to Star Valley Medical Center in sincere appreciation and recognition of your 70 years of membership in the Wyoming Hospital Association. So we've been part of the Wyoming Hospital Association for 70 years. And and this last few months, actually about the last year, we've been kind of questioning our value of being part of the Wyoming Hospital Association. And because part of it is our location, part of it is just, you know, we're a small state and, we seem to be paying dues, and what are we really getting back out of it? So we haven't been real, pleased. And but Rowan Anderson, our board chair, and myself, we kind of got together and said, well, should we be part of the solution to make it better, or should we just complain and get out of it, or just complain about it? And so we're both taking active roles in the Wyoming Hospital Association. He is taking a role. There's a education for board members. That's a major part of the association, and now he's become on that board to do that, and which is very good. And then I've been elected on the Wyoming Hospital Association board, and so we're looking at, instead of complaining about it, let's be part of it. So we're doing that. And then also we have joined the Idaho Hospital Association because of our location. We affiliate with a lot of hospitals in Idaho, and so we can now tap into the training and the resources of the Idaho Hospital Association as well, and we're doing that for a very, very low rate, so it doesn't cost us a lot to do that, but we can take advantage of the resources. So, but at the Wyoming Hospital Association, we also received this award, and I'll just read what this award is. It says, Wyoming Medicaid Providers Excellence Award presented to Star Valley Medical Center for collaboration with Y Health's ER and Readmission Initiatives 2015. So Y Health is the organization that runs the Medicaid program in the state. And the reason we got this award is actually one of our star employees, Chrissy. Actually, she provided avenues for them to collect data. And she has enrolled a lot of people in the community into the health insurance program. So we just want to recognize you and thank you, because this was a big deal of an award. I mean, it was, totally shocked me that they did that. And, it's in different newspapers and things throughout the state. So it was very nice. So do you want to say anything about this honor?
Oh, I was just surprised. Actually, Charlie came up to me one morning and says, congratulations on your award. I'm like, what are you talking about? I was completely like, what did I do? but it's not mine alone. Like the report that we send in to Medicaid, Eli's the one who created that report, which makes my life easier. Like, putting together that information would be a lot more difficult without that report that he created. So it is a collaboration effort, and I'm glad that that they appreciate and we're making changes for people on Medicaid to decrease readmission, help them with their health overall. So it's not just a continuing process of coming in. So I think it's an exciting program that I feel honored that they let me be a part of.
You're being modest, but thank you.
Mm-hmm. There's only two in Wyoming that got that award, so that's pretty good. Mm-hmm.
Okay, next on here is ICU, and we are on schedule for October 7th to start our ICU, finally. We've talked about it for a lot of months, and working the last details out with Intermountain Healthcare, because they're doing our tele-ICU program. So what tele-ICU means is that there will be a doctor in Salt Lake and four nurses that are on 24/7 that will be available to our patients and to our staff. So those nurses are highly trained in ICUs, the doctors trained in, highly trained in ICUs. So having that resource, they can talk, they can look to the patient, that you know, there's the cameras are there that they can focus right in, and you know, if they want to look at a fingernail, they can do that. I mean, it's amazing technology, and the microphones, you can hear just like you're right next to them. It's just amazing technology that they have. And so we're going to be starting that, and another reason why hospitalists are becoming important into the mix of what we're doing, because our acuity level continues to rise. We're keeping more and more patients, and that's a good thing, because the community doesn't necessarily want to drive or get in an ambulance and go to, or a helicopter to go to other hospitals when they can have the care here. So it's very, I mean, it's exciting to see that we can have an ICU. Mike, you're up again.
What am I talking about this time?
You're talking about sensitive inflammation. Oh, okay. You can talk about construction.
All right, thank you. So let's talk about construction first. We had the state inspector here a week ago today. We did the inspection on the new surgery department. And this morning we got our list from him of minor corrections we need to do before we provide service. In there, we'll get our plan of correction back to him probably tomorrow morning sometime. I'd love to see us get from him notice that we can proceed to provide services in the new OR early next week. So now comes all the work for Nolan and Kathy and Tony and their staff, and making sure we can get moved in to the new OR space and get started providing services in there. So that's an exciting thing. That's a nice milestone for Star Valley Medical Center to have that available. The other thing I wanted to visit with you about, if you'll remember, I think it was probably our last all-staff meeting, we talked a little bit about patient privacy and how the community perceives Star Valley Medical Center as maybe not being as protecting of patients' privacy as we maybe could or should be. That's how we're viewed. Whether that's right or wrong, that's the perception the community has of us here at Star Valley Medical Center. So as we thought about that, we felt like, you know, we do MARS training in February that has a component of patient privacy and HIPAA in it to do our MARS. We think we need to do one kind of mid-year for MARS. So here in the next few days, you're going to get an email from the IT department that has a little online course you can take, and it's a very general about protected health information, protected identity information, protected how to guard against credit card fraud. There's several subjects there. They're kind of general, but it's a really good start for us to start thinking more and more about HIPAA, more and more about patient privacy, more and more about what our role is in all of that and how we should handle it. And as part of that course, it will take you about 15 minutes to do that online. And as part of that course, you'll have to click on a link and it will show you a copy of the confidentiality agreement we all signed when we become employees at Star Valley Medical Center. So you'll have to review that agreement again and click on the acknowledgement button that you have read it and agree to abide by it when you finish the course. And then your department director will be notified that you've finished the course, and your directors will be talking to you about that. So I'd like to just encourage you all to do that. When you get that link in your email, go in and do that course. Take you about 15 minutes, and it's really good information, good general information about privacy and security. So I just wanted to let you know that will be coming, and your department director will be talking to you about that. Thanks.
Okay, thank you, Mike. Cokeville Clinic is up and running, and it's actually doing very well. I mean, Connie shared with the earlier group about you know, how she's very appreciative with how all the departments work together to make it happen. But anyway, they are seeing patients. It's going very well. The community is very happy that they have a clinic up and going. So all's good. And so we started with primary care, and then we're going to go, you know, Dr. Tomlinson's going to go there. And we're going to have physical therapy going there. Our orthopedic surgeons will stop because they're driving right by Cookeville already. And so more to come. You know, we're happy about expanding the services. We're looking to do a portable x-ray machine there as well, too. So things are happening.
Sorry, yeah. Mind if I said something about construction? I failed to mention something.
Yeah, go ahead.
You're talking about Cookeville and the OR and... And, you know, we've got a whole long list of construction projects that we're contemplating doing. And I just want to give thanks to the maintenance department for all of the work they're doing, keeping our hospital going from a maintenance perspective, and all of the projects, you know, the new x-ray room they were ever involved in. They're going to be involved in a new CT scanner remodel to get that done. They're going to be doing some work in the laboratory here in the next few days. Just tons and tons of stuff going on. I just want to tell you guys thanks for everything you do.
Thank you. Okay, we're going to go circle clear back to the top. And instead of doing a moment of silence in honor of Teresa Porter, we've got some slides that we want to show you. You know, I think it really does hurt when one of our own, you know, loses their life, and I think it's been very hard, you know, on all of us, and especially the, you know, the materials management department. It's been very hard, but anyway, this is an honor for Teresa.
The trumpets play and the angels sing every sweet refrain of amazing grace, and the heaven's hands opened up again, and the children danced when they saw your face, as happy as they were to see you coming. I was just as sad to have to watch you go. Oh, but knowing what I know about heaven, believing that you're all the way home, knowing that you're somewhere better, is all I need to let you go. I could hope that I could bring you back, but why on earth would I do that when you're somewhere like the love never ends? Oh, no.
Sorry to end the meeting on a sad note, but I think that's, you know, good to honor her. And so, Pam, I know we have some drawings, but it's an opportunity now if anybody has any questions, comments.
And this is a little sad note because I want to talk about paying it forward a little bit. So.
Pam, while you're drawing, there are a couple other that I forgot. Almost every week, there is some type of celebration that goes on nationally for something within healthcare, and I need to send out an apology to the Environmental Services Department. We missed them. Last week was the National Environmental Services Week, so thank them, and if you see them wandering around. And this week is Surgical Tech Week, so if you happen to see a surgical tech not behind the red line out wandering around, pat them on the back and tell them thank you for all that they did. So just to let you know that, so appreciate it.
Awesome. Thank you so much. I'm going to do a little bit different today. So Kristen Heiner and Nolan Heiner. Nolan, I saw you guys, so I already missed out. But Kristen Heiner and Kathy Wright. So somebody tell me what Pay It Forward is, besides Teresa.
We
for the credit card, absolutely everything she did, but
Turn this off.